find lower Riemann sum, upper Riemann sum and oscillatory Riemann sum for the function f of x is equals to 2x plus 1 on the closed interval 1, 2, and the partition P is equals to the set containing the points 1, 4/3, 5/3, 2. We are given the function y is equals to f of x, that is equals to 2x plus 1. This is an increasing function in the closed interval 1, 2, and the partition P consisting of the partition points 1, 4/3, 5/3, 2. Now we have to find upper, lower and oscillatory sum for the function f on the closed interval 1, 2 with respect to the partition P. We know the formula to find the lower sum of f with respect to P is L of P, F, that is equals to sigma I is equal to 1 to n small mi and delta I, where small mi is the infimum of the ith sub interval, delta I is the length of the ith sub interval. Here n is equal to 3 because we are given 4 partition points and hence we will be having only 3 sub interval and hence n is equals to 3. Similarly, the upper Riemann sum f with respect to the partition P is defined as u of P, F is equals to sigma I is equal to 1 to n capital Mi into delta I, where n is equals to 3. The oscillatory sum of f with respect to P is given by the formula omega of P, F is equals to u of P, F minus L of P, F. The function is y equal to 2x plus 1 and the interval is 1, 2 and the partition P is the set containing the points 1, 4/3, 5/3, 2. Since we are given 4 partition points, we will be having 3 sub interval. Therefore, the first sub interval capital I1 is equal to the closed interval 1, 4/3. The second sub interval I2 is equals to 4/3, 5/3. The third sub interval I3 is equal to the closed interval 5/3, 2. Now delta 1 is the length of the first sub interval. That is, we have to find the positive difference between the two endpoints, namely 1, 4/3. That is equals to 4/3 - 1 = 1/3. Delta 2 is the length of the second sub interval I2, that is 5/3 - 4/3, that is equal to 1/3. Delta 3 is the length of the third sub interval I3, that is equals to 2 - 5/3, that is also 1/3. That is delta 1, delta 2, delta 3, each value is 1/3 because the given closed interval 1, 2 is divided into 3 equal parts. Therefore, we have the length 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. We are given the function y is equal to f of x is equal to 2x plus 1 is an increasing function in the closed interval 1, 2. This is the graph of the function y is equals to 2x plus 1. Now let us trace the graph. Now this is a tracing a curve. If you see this, yes, x value is 3.53. What is y value? 8.06. The reason is x is 3.53. Keep x value is 3.53, then y becomes 2 times 3.53 plus 1. That will be equals to 8.06. and remember that when x is 0, y value is 1. This is the one. X is 0, y value is 1. Therefore, this graph y equal to 2x plus 1 does not pass through the origin. This is the origin. It does not pass through the origin. So, this is the graph y equals to 2x plus 1. Let us consider the subinterval I1 that is equal to 1, 4 by 3. We are going to find the infimum, supremum of the function f in the interval I1. Therefore, small m1 is the infimum of f in the subinterval I1 that is equals to f of x is equal to x plus 1 is the function. But we are going to find the infimum of f in the subinterval I1. Since it is an increasing function, the infimum is f of 1. Therefore, f of 1. What is f of 1? F of x is 2x plus 1. Therefore, f of 1 will be 2 into 1 plus 1. That is equals to 3. That is, m1 is the infimum of f in the subinterval I1, that is equals to 3. Now, capital M1 is the supremum of f in the subinterval I1 is equal to the closed interval 1, 4 by 3. The supremum is nothing but f of 4 by 3. What is f of 4 by 3? That is equal to 2 into 4 by 3 plus 1. That is equal to 8 by 3 plus 1. If we take LCM, we have a 8 plus 3 divided by 3, that is 11 by 3. 11 by 3 is the supremum of the given function in the first subinterval. Now let us consider the subinterval I2. Small m2 is the infimum of f in the subinterval I2, that is equal to closed interval 4 by 3, 5 by 3. As we know, that is increasing function. Therefore, infimum is f of 4 by 3. F of 4 by 3 is equals to 2 into 4 by 3 plus 1. That is equal to 4 2s are 8. 8 by 3 plus 1. Take LCM. That is equal to 11 by 3. Capital M2, supremum of f in the subinterval I2. That is equals to the closed interval 4 by 3, 5 by 3. The supremum of f is f of 5 by 3. F of 5 by 3 is equals to 2 into 5 by 3 plus 1. That is 5 2s are 10. 10 by 3 plus 1. Take LCM as 3. Therefore, 10 plus 3 by 3 is equal to 13 by 3. Now, let us consider the subinterval I3. That is equals to the closed interval 5 by 3 comma 2. Now we are going to find the infimum and supremum of the function f in the subinterval I3. So small m3 is the infimum of f in the subinterval I3, that is equal to f of 5 by 3. Just now we have found the value of f of 5 by 3, that is equal to 13 by 3. Now capital M3 is the supremum of f in the subinterval I3, that is equals to closed interval 5 by 3 comma 2, and the supremum is nothing but f of 2. F of 2 is 2 into 2 plus 1, that is equal to 5. Thus we have found infimum and supremum of the function f in I1, I2, I3. Now these are the values of infimum and supremum of the function f in the subinterval I1, I2 and I3. Also, we know that the length of each subinterval is 1 by 3. Now, we are going to find the lower Riemann sum or lower dot box sum L of P, F. The formula for L of P, F here is summation I equal to 1, 2, 3 mi into delta I. Since we know m1, m2, m3 and delta 1, delta 2, delta 3 values, substitute here. If you substitute, we have m1 is 3, m2 is 11 by 3, m3 is 13 by 3, delta 1 is 1 by 3, delta 2 is 1 by 3, delta 3 is 1 by 3, 3 into 1 by 3 is 1, Now to take LCM as 9, we are writing 1 as 9 by 9. This is 11 by 9. This is 13 by 9. 1 by 9 is a common factor. Take it out. Therefore, we get 9 plus 11 plus 13. 9 plus 11 is 20. 20 plus 13 is 33 by 9. That is equal to 11 by 3. That is the lower Riemann sum of the function f with respect to the given partition P is 11 by 3. Now let us find the upper Riemann sum u of p comma f. The formula for this is u of p comma f is equals to sigma I is equal to 1 to 3 capital MI into delta I. Capital M1 is 11 by 3. Capital M2 is 13 by 3. Capital M3 is 5. Delta 1, delta 2 and delta 3 each is equal to 1 by 3. Let us substitute the values of capital M1, capital M2, capital M3 and delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. We get 11 by 9 plus 13 by 9 plus 15 by 9. So 1 by 9 is a common factor. Take it out. Therefore, we get 11 plus 13 plus 15 by 9. 11 plus 13 plus 15 is 39 by 9. That is equals to 13 by 3. Thus, the upper Riemann sum of the given function f with respect to the partition P is 13 by 3. Oscillatory sum is defined as O of P comma F or omega of P comma F, that is equals to U of P comma F minus L of P comma F. That is the positive difference between upper Riemann sum and lower Riemann sum. That is equals to 13 by 3 minus 11 by 3. That is equals to 2 by 3. Thus, the lower Riemann sum is 11 by 3, upper Riemann sum is 13 by 3, oscillatory sum is 2 by 3.